Hello, dear friends. Today in our studio we have me, Mila Serdyukova, and a very unusual guest who you already know. And most likely many of you saw him in person in India. This is Nurlan Mamakeyev, the producer, the author of the idea, the co-owner and the founder of the company KG Club Production, Amalgama and Shadow and Light.
Nurlan Mamakeyev, director, producer, CEO of KG Club Production, the founder of Shadow and Light filmmaking company and the special effects company Amalgama VFX. The author and the creator of more than 15 successful projects in the Asian market. The author of the idea and the screenplay for the first Asian superhero, The Dragon Man. The list of Amalgama's projects includes such films as The Old Rifle, The Icebreaker, Attraction, American Gods, The Scythian, Trotsky, Demon of the Revolution, Chernobyl, The Exclusion Zone, Salute 7, The Gogol Trilogy.
Nurlan, could you please tell us why you chose the filmmaking industry?
You know, since childhood I've enjoyed watching films. For me, cinema is magic. It gets you into an utterly different world. So many things happen in the real life and people want to take their minds off those things. They want to indulge in fantasies. Cinema can take you to the outer space. You can visit the moon, another country. In 2 hours, you can experience an entire adventure, a story. Cinema is about emotions. That's why I chose the filmmaking industry. I didn't get there yesterday or the day before. It took me 15 years to make that choice. I studied the market, the American market, the Russian market, the Asian market, the Indian market, the Chinese market. And I always wondered why a particular film grossed quite a lot while another film was a box office bomb. Eventually, I started understanding what kinds of films you need to make money.
So, we may say that your hobby grew into a passion, a creative passion.
Yes, creative fervor. That's how I'd call it. You know, there are lots of examples where a film with a small budget grossed quite a lot of money, a huge box office success. So I sat down and told myself to name 3 reasons why I couldn't do the same. And I started working to that end. Yes, I shot over 15 films. Several TV series. Our company provided technical support to around 30 projects. We already have experience in the Indian filmmaking industry, the Chinese filmmaking industry. We did quite a lot for many films, including visual effects, and the time has come for us to make our own films and make a profit out of it. Whereas in the past, we made a film and others made a profit off it. It's time we profited from it.
As far as I know, you have plans to develop specifically the Asian market. Could you please elaborate why you chose Asia, India and China, and how you are different from the existing competitors in the market?
We chose specifically Asia because we are indeed going to differ from our competitors. That's why we chose the Asian market. If we go to the American market, it will be difficult for us to implement our projects because they have lots of professionals there. As for the Asian market, it is no secret that special effects in Chinese films are different from those in the Hollywood market. The reason for that is they are just developing. That's why we chose China and India, because no matter what we shoot there, it will be different from their standard films. People will be interested. People always want something new. New technologies come up all the time. 3D, IMAX, they want more new things. And we are the company that is going to be something new for those huge, large-scale film markets.
Yes, indeed. If we take a look at the global market and put Bollywood and the Chinese filmmaking industries together, it's going to be something huge. We are talking about large populations, big opportunities for market development. And as far as I understand, your biggest difference is that you use various special effects. You can create films of any genre and use various special effects.
We do not limit ourselves. We do not limit our imagination. We can make absolutely any film, and I'm saying this with full confidence, and I can give you the video materials of our projects. I think the viewers watching this interview will understand what we're talking about. We can shoot a film about the outer space. We can invent our own world. We can invent new heroes, new protagonists. We can revive already popular, beloved heroes. For example, when we were in India, I offered Mithun Chakraborty to star in a film and he would look the way he did 30 years ago. He was shocked, and when we showed him what it could look like, he was quite interested in it. What I'm saying is that our main advantage is technologies. It is not just about the screenplay, not just the film or its making, but technology. People want emotions, people want amusement. Films made without special effects can be watched at home on your couch. But when they come to the cinema, they want a spectacle. Emotions, explosions, sound, things flying around, something happening every second, something incredible. And ordinary films are losing their appeal. That's our difference.
Great. Indeed, when you go to the cinema, you want the film to be captivating. You want special effects, entertainment. It's very important. I know that in addition to films, you have an entire universe of other products, which are not directly related to films, but they are like film derivatives, like a sub-industry. In India, for example, many partners saw The Dragon Man. Everyone liked the concept of The Dragon Man, this superhero. Using the example of The Dragon Man and any other project, could you tell us how a film stops being just a film and turns into a huge project?
Everyone knows there is a computer game market, mobile apps. The Dragon Man is just the beginning of a big journey. We are going to have the computer game The Dragon Man. We are going to have the Dragon Man costumes. Tomorrow, our Dragon Man can start singing, in any language, by the way. There will be Dragon Man action figures. Everyone thinks that cinema is just going to the movies. There was a time when the United States didn't have enough firemen, and the United States government placed an order for a film about firemen. They asked to show that those guys were saving lives, they were heroes, girls liked them. And after that film, an incredible number of young guys wanted to become firemen. Cinema is influential. You can make an impact with a film. We all remember the boomer film. Everyone wanted to be cool and bought themselves BMWs. Even Germans themselves call this BMW model the boomer. That's how influential cinema is. That's why I think this is an area of great promise.
One can create a masterpiece showing everyone how beautiful our future can be and what it can offer. And if it's launched in huge markets such as China and India, I guess, all other markets will want it as well and will take up on the idea. What are your plans for the future development of such big projects?
We do not limit ourselves to the Chinese and Indian markets. We started from those two markets because they have comfortable startup environment. Even films that are considered box office bombs still yield a very good profit. It is just the beginning. Just the beginning. We do not limit ourselves. We are going to shoot American films as well. We are going to make Russian movies. We are going to make European movies, too. We've never really limited ourselves in this regard. It's just the beginning. It is convenient there. You can make quick money there. It's not that difficult to ensure the distribution of films. That's why we started from those two markets. And since our friendship is now backed by a 100-year contract, we have lots of other ideas, projects, and all of them are related to cinema, in this way or another.
A couple of weeks ago, we reached the mark of 1 million individuals in our fund, in our groups of companies. It means that on the one hand, they are co-owners, but on the other hand, they are also users. So every person can go and watch the film and invite their friends. So, in terms of the return of investments, our collaboration can be mutually beneficial and profitable.
Yes, if they invest in a film and recommend it to 20 of their friends, like go and watch our film, it's already 20 million, multiplied by 5. You can take a calculator and see. And it's just our partners. But we're going to promote this film big time. And I'm kinda afraid of calculating the profits here.
Can you lift a curtain a little bit and tell us when you think the first project will be ready and when we can watch the first film project?
The first project is in production right now. It's more than 60% ready. The film will be ready this year. However, the date of release is a decision which we need to take together. We need to pick the most favorable time for the release of the film. We need to see what is being put into the market right now. We don't want to quickly shoot a film and release it. We want to receive the best profit possible from that film, from that product. We want to receive all kinds of benefits from that product. We are going to have superhero action figures and mobile apps, as I mentioned before, arrangements with TV channels, with websites, with online cinemas. We want to make it in different languages. We'll have it dubbed into English, Russian, possibly Italian. Well, into European languages, different languages, so that a person could pay online and watch it in the language they prefer. It is well known that we have partners from across the entire world who will want to watch the film they invested in. It is not going to be a film in Chinese only, and it will surely reach online platforms.
I'm sure that all the partners from all the countries around the world will gladly join in, because it's a big honor to have such a partner. It seems we started from a small concept, now it's growing into a huge idea. It's a market inside a market inside a market.
Indeed, we plan to produce up to 40 films per year. And to that end, we have both the experience, the resources, and the understanding. One project will serve as a safety net for another project. We'll have different projects. We don't want to focus on a single narrow market. We want to scale up. To scale up at an insane pace. To really scale up our idea, our own universe. I do not restrict my team in any way. I tell them, let your imagination fly. Let's invent a new planet. We invented not just one, but 8 new planets. We added specific features to each planet. people would think, wow. Imagination has no boundaries, right? Thoughts flow fast, and viewers will gladly watch and indulge in fantasies. Imagine there's another world, another planet, other races. That's where we're going. Definitely it is.
I like this concept. The idea of creating future or even present worlds where you can let your imagination go. And everything one dreamed about can be seen through the implementation of new films, projects. As you all know, dear friends, the philosophy of our company is to create the new economic evolution of the world. Do you think it is possible to create a project where we could show what the new economic evolution of the world is, and how all people can participate in it, and how they can benefit from it, how the world will change physically, emotionally? Do you think it's possible using your technologies?
Definitely it is. Every person creates their own obstacles. Nobody prevents you from having a good life. Nobody prevents you from having a beautiful life, a better life, being rich and being happy. Nobody prevents it. And as I said before, cinema is influential. A person might watch our film, become inspired, and do what we showed in the film. A person can see the future, here and now. With the current growth of technologies, you can imagine what it's going to be like in 200 years. Unfortunately, we won't see it, but we can get a glimpse of what it's going to be like in 200 years through our projects.
Certainly. And already today, we can make step towards becoming better ourselves and creating this future today. Great, dear friends. It's very difficult to me to put into words the feeling of inspiration that I'm having, the goosebumps. Nurlan is telling such an interesting story that I can already image the film in my head, honestly. It's so great to have such business partners, creative partners, who have a clear understanding how to make films profitable. Here, no matter how I look at it, I can see only a win-win situation.
Absolutely right. But we didn't do it overnight. It took us 15 years to get there. We learned from our mistakes. We have lots of experience. And now the time has come to reap the rewards.
Thank you for your answers. It was quite useful to hear them. And in conclusion, what would you like to wish to our listeners, partners? What would be your parting words?
I would like to address all our partners, all viewers watching our interview, and even our future partners. Let's be together. Let's develop together. Aim higher. And be richer. And most importantly, happier.
Yes, indeed, it's very important to feel happiness, energy inside. And here, in the same room with Nurlan, I am overwhelmed. I can feel shivers down my spine, especially after Nurlan told us about his future projects. And I'm very glad that today we have such a creative partner. Thank you very much, friends, for being with us and looking forward to meeting you again. Goodbye.